Your website has been upgraded to the newest version of our website building software, Wildfire 5. I want to take some time to go over some of the main differences that you will notice in Wildfire 5, and also show you some of the new features that we think will be a great improvement to both the way that you build the website, as well as the way your website visitors will interact with your content. Okay, so let's get to it. So, to log into your website, you'll need to find the login button. It will be at the very bottom of the page in the footer. Once you find it and click it, you can log in as normal. Okay, so first looking in your administration screen in Wildfire 5, you'll see that it's not that different than the previous version. The black menu bar at the top is quite similar, and the choices you get on the submenu, or the white bar, are mostly the same, with just a few different options. We have simplified our themes to match current website design trends. We have less selections to avoid any confusion. We currently only have 4 different themes, and you could experiment with them if you like. As you scroll through and look at them, you will find a short description about each one. The main difference between the themes is how the menu bar looks and behaves. In all cases, the menu bar on the top is minimized to give you more room on the screen for your content, and it also provides a more modern look for your website. Previously, many of our themes supported banner images and background images. These images would apply to every page of your website. Current website design has gone away from this technique, and our new themes no longer support this. If your website had a banner or a background image, you will notice some changes right away. Here, in the upgraded version of this website, you'll see that the banner image is now at the top of the home page, but it's not on any of the other pages of the site. Background images have been removed completely. One thing that's consistent in all of the themes is the way that the language buttons are now displayed. Previously, we had one button for each language at the top, and this was cluttering up the menu a little bit. So now, we have a drop-down. When you click on it, all the languages for the website will be listed here. The way pages are constructed is one of the biggest changes in Wildfire 5. In the past, you created your pages in a large text editor. That has gone away, and what has replaced it is what we believe is a more intuitive and flexible way to arrange your pages. This is what we call the layout builder. Your content will be added here in the form of content blocks, which will be arranged on your page in a framework. When you are starting from a blank page, the only thing you'll be able to do here is add a section. Think of a section as a horizontal row on your site. When I click Add Section, the sidebar opens, and I have a choice to make. I can choose if I want my section to have 1, 2, 3, or 4 columns. Columns are the vertical components on your page. For example, here I'm going to choose 2 columns. Now you will see that I have the framework to start adding the content. So now I will select Add Content, and again the sidebar opens, and I have lots of choices here. These are the content blocks that I can add to my web page. These are such things as audio, video, text, image, PDF, apps, and many other options. Just to show you how this works, I will choose Image, and I'm going to add a photo to this block. In the other column, I'm also going to add some content. So I'll click Add Content, and then I will select Text. Here you'll see that a text editor opens, and I can type my text in here. After you save, You will see a preview of the page. At this point, I can add another section either above or below this section, or I can add more content to one of the columns. Every time I add a new section, it will ask me how many columns. You can change it up, so sometimes you have two columns, and below that you might have three, or one, or four columns. Also on this page, you'll see that I can configure any existing section. I can adjust the column widths. They don't have to be 50-50. I can adjust the width of the section itself. This one's very important. Each section can be either edge to edge or really narrow if you want margin on the sides, or it can be anywhere in between. So feel free to experiment with these and see what they look like on your web page. And different sections on your page can have different widths. As somebody scrolls from top to bottom, it might change a little bit. I can also adjust the space above the section, so I can add a gap between the sections. I can also add more space between the columns. I can add a background to the section, either color or image. And I can also adjust the fine-tune settings of each column right here. I could change the background color, or I can add margin to a column. After you save, you will see a preview of the page, but I still need to scroll either to the top or to the bottom of the page and click Save to make sure that this page is saved. This might take a little bit of time to get used to, but your current sites have already been converted to this format. So now you can go in, edit your pages by clicking Edit Layout, and then you'll see a pencil icon on each content block. So if you click on the pencil and edit, now you can change the content. There's more details on all of this on our help site. So if you go to the top of Wildfire, you'll see the help button. That will take you to our help site. One of the other main changes in the way that the pages are constructed is how you translate the text to other navigation languages. It is important to note that the old way of side-by-side page working screens is handled differently now. Your default language is presumably the language that you are creating the website in, so it is also the source language. In the case of this example, it's English. So now I need to translate this to my second language. So I select that language in the top right. So now I have to click Edit Layout. And to edit the text block, I click the pencil icon and edit. You'll see that the English is carried over, but I need to change it and translate it. So I can actually just delete this text and put in my new language. But also you'll see below that I have my source text to refer to. Okay, now I will try to edit this picture. A caption on the text box appears to let me translate the caption, but notice that I cannot edit the photo itself. In Wildfire 5, I'm not allowed to change any content blocks in a language that is not the default language. You'll see this message here in the Layout Builder at the top, so you're always aware of that. There's a new way to arrange your menu links in Wildfire 5. In my Wildfire 5 site, I'll go to Work with Pages and Overview, and I come to the Overview screen. If you remember, in the previous version of Wildfire, there was a cross arrow icon that was located here, and you can drag and drop these pages up and down to put them in different parts of the menu. You don't see that on this screen here. In Wildfire 5, we have to go to another screen, which is called Arrange menu links. So at the top, next to Overview, you'll see this link. So that takes you to this page, which has the familiar icons that you could grab. You could drag them up and down, or you could drag them to the left or right to make them sub-menu items. And you just do that from this page now instead of the overview screen. So this is just a minor difference. It is done the same way, but it's in a different location. Going back to the overview screen, there's a new feature here I'd like to point out. If you click on Show Advanced Actions over here on the right, you'll see that there's a new icon on the far left. This is the Copy button. This allows you to actually make a copy of an entire web page on your website. The reason you'd want to do this is if you have a page set up and you'd like to use it sort of as a template, a lot of the features are the same on another page, you can copy it and edit it. You could see more details about this in one of our tutorial videos. The next thing that I'd like to show you is the new Media Library. This is another substantial change in Wildfire 5. On the top menu bar, I'll click on Work with Media. Then I'll click on Media Library. The Media Library is where all of the files you upload to your website are stored. I could also add media from here, which is especially helpful when I'm uploading many files at one time. You'll need to choose one of six types of media to upload to your library. You can choose to view your library as a list or in a grid format. So now, all of your files are in one place. The old file manager system is gone, and everything appears here together. You can use the filter to help you find things easier. If you know the name of the media, you can type it here, or you can just type a few characters to narrow your search. You can filter by media type. Tags are keywords that you can apply to your media files to group them. It's very helpful to use when searching. Here in the list view, I can sort my media by clicking on the title in the header. I can also choose to edit or delete any media from here. By using the checkboxes, I can do a couple of bulk actions, such as delete several media at once, or I can apply a tag to several media files for easier filtering. Now that you've seen many of the new ways to work within Wildfire, there are also some new features that I'd like to show you. These are located on our Wildfire 5 Help site, which you can get to by clicking on Help. You'll see this link here at the top, Example Content. This will show you how some of the content blocks will appear in Wildfire 5. Let me start by showing you some of the new features that we added. One of them is called Image with Text. You can now add text right on top of an image on your website. The advantage of this feature is that the text can be translated to each of your navigation languages, and you can make this text a clickable hyperlink. Or you can place a clickable button on the image, which gives you an opportunity to create a call to action for your audience. Image with Text also allows you some other options, such as placing text next to the image instead of on top, or you can use the wrap text style, which is useful if you have a lot more text and you want it to wrap around the image. Another new feature is Verse of the Day. This feature will display a new Bible verse every day automatically on your website. You can choose if the verse is displayed on an image, on a solid color background, with no background at all, or with border art. The verse will automatically be changed every day, so your visitors will see something new on your site. And another new feature is the ability to integrate in your website the Lumo project. In partnership with Faith Comes by Hearing, If one of the gospel films has been created in your publication language, we can seamlessly stream the video on your website in this customized video player. Speaking of Faith Comes by Hearing, we still support streaming audio players in this custom player directly on your site. Your own audio files can be displayed in separate audio players, or we still support a playlist option, but now we offer three different styles of playlists which you can choose from. As always, you can upload your own video to your website. Your video files can be displayed in a single player, or you can choose which style of playlist to use. Of course, we still support remote videos, such as YouTube and Vimeo. And the last thing I want to point out here are slideshows. We still support image slideshows, which look very similar to how they used to look. However, now you'll be able to configure each slide. You can add text on the image. You can make it clickable. Or you can add a button to any image. You can also make the image itself clickable to take you to another link. You can add text next to an image in a slideshow. So your slides can contain any combination of the above. This gives you many new features to include in your slideshows. Thanks for watching. If you need more help, come to our Wildfire Help website at 5.wildfirehelp.net. Here you can find documentation. Make sure to look under Unit 2. And you'll see a lot of topics listed here. Or you can browse through our tutorial videos and look for a topic that might help you. If you need further help, reach out to your digital publishing manager, or you can email info@wildfirehelp.net.